I've loved space since I was probably in third grade. I remember there were lots of spacewalks that I used to watch on TV, and the astronauts in their big white spacesuits and the big American flag on the side just made it look like something I wanted to be a part of. That or dinosaurs, I'm just saying. Everybody loves dinosaurs.
Tara is very loyal. She never gives up on anything. She's dependable, she's funny, she's dedicated, and she loves space.
Tara has never wanted to be anything but an astronaut and work for NASA. Space camp is something I learned about from her. I actually thought it was just in a movie, and she's one who taught me that actually you can go to space camp.
Tara Ruttley was 11 years old when she first saw the movie Space Camp. She thought that such a place couldn't be real.
We didn't have internet back then. So I would go through the phone books, and sure enough, found out there is a space camp and it's real and it's in Huntsville, Alabama. So for a few years, I would send off for the catalogs, and they would send them back to me with the dates and the price.
Tara expressed her wish to attend space camp to her parents, but it was more than they could afford at the time. Over the next few years, Tara's parents began saving the money to send her to space camp. Finally, Tara was able to attend the summer of her junior year in high school.
If I looked at my life like a flat line, the summer of my junior year would go beep. What it really was magical. You walked into this big building with all these space toys everywhere, and you get to use them. And not only do you get to use them, you get to be part of a team that uses them in synchrony. All the kids feel the same way you do. They love space, they want to be here, they're interested. So you've immediately found your family of others who you didn't know existed, just like you. It was the one thing in my life that has the biggest influence on me throughout the rest of my career, I think.
Space camp was a catalyst. I mean, that started it all. That was best money I ever spent.
After high school, Tara briefly attended Michigan State University before transferring to Colorado State. During the transition period, Tara came back to space camp to work as a counselor alongside her now husband and childhood sweetheart, Paul, who himself was working as a counselor for Aviation Challenge.
I think it was just one of those transition periods that worked out really good for us. She was doing what she wanted to do and what she was passionate about on the space side. It was a fun time.
Once at Colorado State University, Tara continued to pursue her dreams by getting her Bachelor's of Science in Biology and her Master's in Mechanical Engineering. Then in 2001, Tara was with some fellow college students in Houston, Texas, doing parabolic flight science experiments. While there, Tara attended a job fair at Johnson Space Center.
I applied thinking, actually got a phone call 2 days later while I was still here in Houston. There was a brand new organization opening up called the Biomedical Systems Division, and they needed someone with a biology and an engineering background. So talk about preparation meeting opportunity. That's the perfect example, and that's how I ended up at NASA.
Since coming to NASA, Tara has advanced within her career. In July 2004, she became an aquanaut working on the Nemo 6 program, where she lived and worked underwater for 10 days. She also found the time to get her Ph.D. in neuroscience, graduating from the University of Texas Medical Branch at Galveston in 2007. Tara now works as the associate program scientist for the International Space Station at Johnson Space Center.
I work with the chief scientist for the space station program to ensure that all the research gets done on space station that's supposed to get done. It's done in a way that pleases the researchers and gets the best value back to the community here on Earth.
With dreams of still going to space herself, Tara likes to encourage STEM education any chance she gets, especially for young girls like her own daughter.
The value in encouraging STEM education and training is that you're providing an investment in our future.
And as those kids come back, I want to be like her. How did she start? And the first thing I'll say, well, she went to space camp and tell those space camp stories.
To be inducted into the Space Camp Hall of Fame is pretty cool. I think I'm joining a group of really great professionals who love space just as much or more, if it's possible, than I do. Now I feel like it's really great to be honored and to be a part of that group who can help work together and keep that momentum going and keep investing and reinvesting into the programs.
She actually said what she wanted to do when we were very young, and she set out and she completed it. There's not a better person or more deserving than Tara to be inducted into the Hall of Fame.